Dayan has been reborn. Word of King Peleus' coronation reaches neighboring Crimea within days. Crimea itself has spent the past 3 years rebuilding from the damage it suffered during the Mad King's War. News that Ashnard's son now sits on Dayan's throne sends waves of unease and worry rippling across the land. Alas, this is not the only thing disturbing the people of Crimea during this time. There is an ever-widening gap emerging between Crimea's noble class and the nation's young ruler, Queen Elincia. Crimea lost its king during the Dayan invasion, and Elincia is still an inexperienced ruler. What's more, her very existence was a secret from the public, and so she came unexpectedly to her succession. Many of Crimea's noble houses raised their voices in protest against her rule. Elincia's desire for a long-lasting peace has driven her to strengthen Crimea's ties with the Laguz nation of Gallia, and to renounce Crimea's claim to rule over a defeated Dayan. Her political moderation is seen as a sign of weakness among her critics. Ike, the young hero who led Crimea to victory in the Mad King's War, was granted a peerage for his heroism and bravery. The elevation of a common mercenary to the nobility, however, widened the rift between the aristocracy and the queen yet further. Perhaps to avoid becoming mired in these power struggles, Ike renounced his peerage and took his leave of the court. Yet Ike's actions did little to placate the nobility. They continued to criticize the queen's every decision and lay squarely at her feet the blame for all of Crimea's woes.
Thank you. Okay.